Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sergeant First Class Chris Brannigan, and on behalf of our commander, Colonel Timothy Holton, and Command Sergeant Major Dan Smith, I'd like to welcome you to Orchestra Night here at the 2016 American Trombone Workshop. I'd also like to welcome those of you that are watching us online. You've heard me say this quite a few times here this week already, that our web stream has become a really important part of this event, and our concerts are enjoyed by music lovers all over the U.S. and many different parts of the world. And the best part of our streaming service on YouTube is that as soon as each of these performances have been completed, they're automatically archived on our YouTube channel for you to go back and enjoy anytime you like. The link to that YouTube channel and lots of other great information about Pershing's Own can be found on our website, usarmyband.com, which I'll talk more about later. We have a wonderful evening of music planned for you tonight, from hallmarks of the standard solo repertoire to two new and exciting pieces for both tenor and bass trombone. We open tonight's concert with the U.S. Army Orchestra performing Dmitri Kabalevsky's crisp and lively overture to Kolas Brunjon. Please join me in welcoming to the podium the Deputy Commander of Pershing's Own, Major Treg Onsalay. And if you'll please rise and join us in the singing of the national anthem.
Thank you.
Our first soloist tonight comes to us from one of the finest symphony orchestras in the world. Prior to joining the Cleveland Orchestra in 2009 as assistant principal trombone, Shahar Israel maintained an active schedule as an orchestral trombonist, a soloist, and chamber musician, including solo performances at New York City's Lincoln Center and as trombonist with Canadian Brass. Shahar is also a committed educator who currently serves on the music faculty at Cleveland State University and is the founder and director of the Cleveland Trombone Seminar, a highly successful annual event that brings together motivated students and world-class professional musicians for an intensive week-long learning and performing experience. He's featured tonight on one of the most well-known works in the tenor trombone solo repertoire, the concerto by Lonnie Grondahl. This thoughtful and melodic concerto was composed in 1924 and is the Danish composer's most popular work. It consists of three movements that are basically in the same tempo, but vary widely in character. The piece beautifully highlights the trombone's expressive power. And to borrow a phrase from one reviewer, the work is not short on sweeping lush themes with just a bit of Scandinavian intensity. Please welcome to the stage Associate Conductor First Lieutenant Richard Hennebry and our soloist Shahar Israel.
Thank you.
Tonight's bass trombone soloist is a native Texan who was accepted to the Philadelphia's Curtis Institute of Music when he was just 16 years old. He's performed with some of the country's leading orchestras and brass chamber ensembles, and previously held the position of bass trombone with the Jacksonville Symphony Orchestra. He currently holds the position of principal bass trombone with the Malaysian Philharmonic in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. We are fortunate to feature Zach tonight in the world premiere of Sheridan Seyfried's Concerto for Bass Trombone and Orchestra. We are also fortunate to have the composer here with us this evening. Of this new work, which was a close collaboration between the soloist and composer, Sheridan writes, "The bass trombone to me is an instrument with a commanding, dark-hued voice, perhaps even a prophetic quality. It's an instrument that can play with brilliance and edge in its lower register, more so than a tuba or double bass, but can also sound rich and full throughout all ranges. I tried to write a grand, big piece with drama and plenty of mystery and darkness, as well as a level of intensity that I thought matched the character of the instrument itself." Tonight we're pleased to feature the world premiere of Sheridan Seyfried's Concerto for Bass Trombone and Orchestra. Please welcome to the stage the commander of the U.S. Army Band Pershing Zone, Colonel Timothy Holden, and our soloist, Zach Bond.
Thank you.
The U.S. Army Orchestra is one of nearly a dozen ensembles that make up the U.S. Army Band Pershing Zone. I've mentioned that website before, but if you'd like to learn more about who we are and what we do, I invite you to visit that website once again, usarmyband.com, and also give us a follow on Facebook and Twitter. Links to both can be found on that homepage. While you're there, I invite you to check out our calendar of events, which has a complete listing of all the performances that the U.S. Army Band gives throughout the entire year, as well as links to the live web streams of each and every concert that takes place here in Brucker Hall. We're going to continue now with a short piece by Percy Granger featuring the U.S. Army Orchestra, and it would be a good time for me to mention that we're hiring trombonists and trumpet players and percussionists and French horn players and music arrangers and a few other positions as well. You can find listings of all these openings on that vacancies page on our website. The application deadline for our trombone audition is April 8th, and the live audition is scheduled for June 13th, which is just a week after the International Trombone Festival, taking place just a few hours up the road in New York City at the Juilliard School. On that vacancies page of our website, you'll also find links to the broader Army Music Program. And if you've enjoyed what you've heard so far tonight and throughout this week, know that the musicians on stage represent the excellence that's found across Army music. So Major Ancelet is back to lead the orchestra. Please enjoy Percy Granger's Country Gardens.
Thank you.
Our final soloist tonight is the principal trombonist of the Puerto Rico Symphony, and he's currently on sabbatical leave undertaking a doctoral degree at Northwestern University. Luis Fred has performed with some of the greatest orchestras in America, the Houston Symphony, the Los Angeles Philharmonic, the New York Philharmonic, and most recently with the Chicago Symphony. Tonight we feature Luis in Jim Stevenson's Concerto Brasiliano. We are extremely fortunate, as with Sheridan, to have the composer with us in attendance this evening. Stevenson's exciting trombone concerto was created on short notice and for a special circumstance. In 2006, Jim was engaged to perform as a trumpet player in a music festival in the Caribbean on St. Bart's. I'm sure it was a really rough gig, Jim, I can only imagine. In looking at the proposed program, Jim noticed a slot that indicated peace to be determined. And I'll quote Jim directly here, "Those are dangerous words to mention to a composer." The concerto that resulted just a few months later, after a bit of back and forth with the festival organizers, is in one movement form with a lush, dramatic opening that works its way into bossa nova style rhythms and an exciting finale inspired by the music of Brazil. It's been a pleasure performing for you tonight, and we close our concert with Jim Stevenson's Concerto Brasiliano. Please join me in welcoming our final soloist for this evening, Luis Fred.
The Thank you.